Okay. It's 1220. $22.55. We're gonna give it another shot here. There it is. Four mags, didn't find nothing wrong nowhere. I've got my suspicions what the problem is. I think the magnets are now closer to each other, and I think they're interfering with each other. Thank you. It's 12/19/2013. I have got 4 1-inch mags in this now. One on each corner. I got them pretty well spaced, but not too far, not too close. This should work. I haven't tried it yet. Get a small little test of it, and I've got a signal. Now, I was thinking, how do you extract energy off of that? You could use one of these. Trim the open ends so you got an open area there to catch any field. Turn sideways or whatever. The problem is these 1-inchers at this distance, which is about 10, 12 inches apart, they interact as it is. Putting 4 more in there would really be tricky, getting them not to interact. But the problem is, to get these things this close, they would like them to be about 10 millimeters away. This will cause too much of a pull on those mags. Way too much. Every time it goes by, it'll just grab it. So, it's the only change. I've got the 4 1-inch mags from the last disaster. The one mag came off, rolled around, created sparks, and nailed the other one and broke all 4, both bonds. Had to put those back together, got 2 more, and it should be ready. Should. I don't know. Interesting is the current here. I was looking at the other videos, and the current on this, it seemed to peak no matter how much faster it went. The current did not go up. The voltage did, but the current did not go up on the drill, the load on the drill. So that may have something to do with it. Oh, what I wanted to catch. Hang on. Okay, it's 5 amps, 30 volts. The reason for this unstable pattern is because these rollers, as they're going past each stator mag, they'll slip until it gets near the next one, and it'll slip again, and it'll slip. So until it gets up to speed, and the speed matches the slipping, it'll put out a pattern like that. Come on.
numbers as heavy.
Check the polarity on it. There's something wrong with it. There's just one. So that's a preliminary. The frequency here, I do believe that's setting up eddy currents in that aluminum wheel. The wire is on the outside of the wheel, yet still there's a sine wave coming through it. And it has a set pattern going through it, and this may be an alternating have some significance. I gotta find that bad magnet.